I feel very comfortable. Like, I was training hard all the 6 weeks, I think, when this was announced per fight. So, just feel very comfortable. Just after the lost comeback, so I think was training much harder than usual. So, we'll see.
M.GERVE at the prep point. His opponent tonight will be W.STRUIK. And he wants to be called Dirty W.STRUIK now. He's a HIT Fighting Championships veteran. So I'm very excited for this clash between these two heavyweight fighters. Welcome, Mindaugas Gerve.
And in the red corner, we call W.STRUIK.
Dirty W.STRUIK is the enemy, the opponent of Mindaugas Gerve tonight. 113.3 kilograms. Welcome back, Willem. In his last bout,
the only thing I know is that he's a big guy. It's the only thing. It doesn't matter. I'm a striker. I can grapple also. I don't care where the fight's gonna end, but it's not gonna be a decision, that's for sure. Last time was good. Now I'm better prepared, better trainers camp, stuff like that. I'm serious now, so I'm gonna knock my opponent out. It's gonna be better than it was last time. This time it's gonna be better, harder, quicker. That's what it's gonna be.
Welcome, Dirty W.STRUIK. The fighter from Apeldoorn.
Ladies and gentlemen, he fights to my right out of the blue corner. He wears black and orange. He stands 205 centimeter tall and weighed in at 115.6 kilograms. This fighter comes to us with a record of 2 wins, 1 by knockout and 1 by submission against 1 defeat. He represents IFS Northern Ireland, fighting out of Belfast, Northern Ireland by way of Lithuania. Please welcome Mindaugas the Carl Gerve! Across the cage, out of the red corner, he wears the blue trunks with the red and white trims. He stands 185 centimeters tall and weighed in at 113.3 kilograms. He comes to us with 2 wins, both wins by way of knockout against only 1 defeat. He represents Team Hubert Haven, fighting out of Apeldoorn, the Netherlands. Please welcome Dirty W.STRUIK!
I am pumped for this one, ladies and gentlemen. Dirty W.STRUIK against Mindaugas the Carl Gerve. 115 kilos versus 113.3 kilos. Apeldoorn, the Netherlands versus Lithuania. And we were marveling at Mindaugas Gerve.
And I was marveling at one thing. Have you seen the flag in Struik's corner? That is the flag of the travelers. That means we see some snatch action here.
It could be.
Some traveling man boxing here. Some bare knuckle action with gloves.
Don't blink for this one.
Oh no. Gerve's is like a Hulk. He is probably the Hulk.
He could very well be. But don't sleep on Willem. Oh. Because Willem has fast striking, and he might not have the looks, but he's a strong fighter.
Willem and he shows a very heavy Morton in his last appearance here at HIT-FC. Oh, nice body shot.
Nice body shot, yeah. Willem already showed that he has fast and good striking. Double underhooks here. Willem fights out of it. The call on his knees. But gets wrestled over by Struijk.
Very nice by Struijk.
Half guard here for Struijk. And trying to get out of a guy which weighs 113 kilos. It's very well might not be possible.
Nope.
Oh, he reverses him, of course. As soon as I tell it.
It doesn't even exist. That should not happen.
No, it should not happen. If you know anything about the ground game, this reversal should not happen. But it happened.
Yep.
In the second, I told that he can't reverse it.
Very nice.
Neck crank. He has one arm behind and lost it. Yeah, immediately move to side mount.
Corner, calling the for corner. Elbows.
Yeah, I don't see that. I mean, I could give him a bit better tips what he should do here, but yeah.
Well, elbows is never a good bad tip.
No, I mean you can try to throw elbows here, but. It seems like he tries to trap the right arm of Strike here, but don't quite see the strategy.
Strike is doing a good job.
Yep.
He's staying calm. He's relaxing. Look, he's actually trying to find his way to the cage to get up here.
He shrimps.
Moving his hips.
He shrimps on the ground. Yep. That's quite good.
Very nice job here by Strike.
Not the first time on the ground for Strike. Now there is a position for elbows. Now you have it. And he threatens with a choke.
Yeah. Oh, he pins him now.
Something was. There's something on the floor there. I hope it's not a teeth. A tooth. That was a palm strike.
Very nice. Some slap action going on.
Very nice, very nice by Schroik. Yeah. He's back on his feet.
Oh,
whoa, swing nice and miss.
He's so tall, he just elbowed right on over him.
Let's see what. Struijk does a good job by moving around and staying light on his feet. And this is not a light guy, so.
I have to say something. Struijk is probably a light heavyweight, not a heavyweight.
Yeah, it might be. Why does he try to take him down here? He would have had the reach, so.
I think he feels more comfortable having Struijk on his back than actually punching at him, because Struijk always has to punch his chance.
He knocked
out Luke Morton in his last fight.
Yeah, you're actually right about this.
Probably saw that one. Oh,
that we are right within the action, and these are hard strikes by M.GERVE here.
Oh wow!
Yeah, these strikes are hurting Struijk very bad.
Hammers.
Oh, he walked right into a knee when he tried to get up. Yeah, he walked right into it. He's actually complaining by the referee that he was kneeing the head, but he moved into the knee, so that was no foul.
But Struijk is defending.
Struijk is very well defending.
The referee should not intervene here.
Nope, and he stops.
He's trying to get up.
Yeah, the punches should rain. Good control by M.GERVE here, but.
Look at the size of this guy's head.
He's going for a neck crank here, or he tried at least. And Struijk again on his feet. Unbelievable, the fight in that guy.
Yep.
And he reversed.
Oh,
he reversed M.GERVE here.
He could actually tire Gervais out. Maybe
yes.
The big man's getting tired.
It quite really looks like that, yeah.
He was working very hard here in the first round. Obviously, he won the first round. Gervais is But I think, don't sleep on Struik.
No, no.
There you go, handshake. Thank you.
Handshake, let's go back to the corner, reset. Next round.
Yep.
I like that fight. It is quite unusual for a heavyweight fight to be that action-packed. With scrambles, with grappling, with striking.
Beautiful.
I like it.
And if your nickname is Dirty, I mean, that's the kind of fights you're in.
Let me tell you that he specifically wanted us to say Dirty first.
Yeah.
Before his name, before his first name, before his last name, I'm Dirty W.STRUIK.
He is Dirty.
So it's... call it
just
the...
muscling through.
Let's call it the Mindaugas reversal from now on.
He's got the Lithuanian leverage.
I think Willem should continue what he's doing.
Willem needs to strike. There is no need to go to the ground.
Nope.
He's got to defend the takedown, make Gervais tired, and try to set his punches.
I think Willem is not that tired that Mindaugas is. And he caught him. He caught him.
Oh,
nice body shot.
That body shot.
But he connected in the scramble as well. Yeah, but you're right. The Lithuanian doesn't want anything to do with the takedowns.
Yeah.
With the stand up of Struik. And Struik does the right thing. He wants to get him up.
He wants to strike.
Very nice.
He wants an old fashioned shootout here.
And that is the right thing to do. Nice with the switches. Yeah. He has an unusual footwork, but it's a very good footwork and very good distance.
His hands very low.
Yo, that is dangerous because. Whoa, the shoot was telegraphed, but he manages to wrestle him to the ground. But
that's poor power.
Yep.
No technique, just poor power. Little Kimura attempt here by Struik from the bottom here.
Yeah,
that's probably just a sweep, just to try to sweep.
Try to sweep, or even just trying to control the arm of Mindaugas. Didn't succeed, but he's actually on both knees. He can stand up here. Struik can stand up here. Mindaugas is too far away. He's too far away. No, no.
Nope. There you go.
He can stand. He still can stand up here.
That's more difficult because Gervais keeps weight now on top.
No,
there
you see.
Now he goes for his own takedown.
Oh, very nice.
Just sacks down to the floor.
He slips.
Wants no part of that.
Like on a water slide,
he slides. Tired.
Yes. I think Struik can kill him now.
Struik is not a spring chicken, but
Struik can land a shot here and put Mindaugas out of this fight. The inside leg kicks are distracting Mindaugas as well. And the reversal with the knee. Wow! He caught him with the knee and goes in for the finish, for the kill.
A Hail Mary takedown by Gervais. Gets it, so now he can
so close. It was so close.
But, there is one more round coming. It's still 2:25 left, but
So close that the fight IQ of Mindaugas is good because the only thing left to do was to take him down, and he managed to do it.
Yeah.
Struik shields him now with his right knee. Tries to get a bit more distance, but Mindaugas is tall, of course, so it's difficult to defend yourself with this kind of defense.
Gervais is taking a rest now.
Yep.
He's not working that much, he's just taking a rest.
Yeah, you're right. But the defensive game of Dirty is good. He does the right thing, he controls the arms, he moves around. Yep. The guard is... Now he closed the guard a bit, which is good. I think even Mindaugas is too tall to strike him here. He strikes He's too high up. He's too high up to actually muster the power and the speed he needs to connect with the head of Struik.
Well, maybe the chest here by Struik is like a weapon.
Jesus Christ!
Not much action now.
Not quite sure if taking a break is the right thing to do here for Mindegas, and not much is happening here.
No.
Don't think these... I mean, it's resting for Struik as well.
But the guard is wide open by Struik. Now he closes it again.
I don't think Mindegas knows what to do here.
Yeah.
He has no options.
I think now the referee could move in for a stand-up.
Yeah, he's close to doing it, yeah. I think. It's difficult because some of these strikes of Mindegas would... Yeah, the corner of Mindegas is quite sure that he has two rounds in his bag, but I am not so sure.
I would say yes, because there's a lot of control now.
A lot of control, yes. Yeah. You're right.
But a lot can happen in a third round. And
I think Struik is closer to the finish than Mindegas is.
Yeah.
Control, Struik, I give you that, but...
Absolutely. Struik is not out of that fight.
Nope. Yes, he looks tired, but Mindegas is much more tired.
Really tired. By Struik, who was just starting to unload punches on Gervais.
It's quite impressive how deep the double leg of Mindegas is, because he's such a tall guy, and Struik is very, very compressed, very small in comparison to Mindegas. So let's give him that. The level change is impressive.
Very good, very good.
So a third round in a heavyweight fight, who would have thought?
Wow, by these two guys.
Who would have thought?
Yeah.
I wouldn't say that he looks that tired, Willem.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, wait with the show of sportsmanship till the end, please. Oh, that was a hard jab connected with Willem.
Oh, nice kick.
Nice mid kick and Struik. A swing. That hook connected. But the jabs now Mindegas is finding his jab game, and that's what he should have done.
Oh,
swing and miss.
Punch. And again, Gervais for the takedown. Yeah. And he's probably going to get it, yeah. Oh, nice. Beautiful takedown here.
Beautiful takedown. Now in a much better position than he was before. I think he's inside mount. Yes, he is. The corner of Mindegas is driving the point home that they think Willem is tired.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Well, they were screaming that since the first round.
Yeah. Nice elbow by Willem, actually. Yeah, call for action by the referee, very good. I like the referee. I like the referee tonight.
Yeah, Gervais just resting.
Yeah. Oh, these strikes won't finish the contest. I mean, it is total control, of course.
Yeah. But there's a lot of things you could do here. You could go for a Kimura for armbar. You could actually go for a side choke.
You could go for full mount.
Yeah,
you
absolutely.
Could try to knee on belly.
Absolutely. But
even
that.
Some leg locks are here. Now especially.
Oh, yeah.
With the crossed leg of Willem Struik.
He would have a field day with that leg.
Now he actually tries to improve his position.
Mount.
Very good. And he's full mount now. Willem has to watch out that he does
nice
not turn on.
Here.
Has he a chokehold here?
Yeah, he had it for just a split second. If he postures up now, you have that big fellow raining down punches on you.
That is total
That's
control here. No. Willem has to control the arms of Mindegas now. That is the only thing left to do. I don't know if they, if the corner of Mindegos has an, knows any other words than tired.
Now that was good by Gerve.
Yeah,
but he could. I mean, he's controlling the fight. He's in mount, so the ref will not stand him back up.
He can't stand him. He
no,
can't stand him back up.
And, but he's not doing much. But he's just controlling the fight. I mean, Struik.
Yeah.
He just can't get up.
Now he postures up.
Struik has to turn and tries to.
He actually turned back to the cage now and has a bit more leverage with his leg. But I think we're seeing. I mean, he could go the full 2 minutes.
Oh yeah. Oh, oh.
But Willem is swift on the ground. Yeah, I must say. Way better control now, and he now has to give up his back. He's high up.
Yeah.
If Willem manages to stand up here or get on his knees, Mindegos is very, very high up. He could slide off. He tries to catch the arm, but now he's in a much better position. That will be difficult to escape that one. Yeah, the call for the left hand is the right call. He has to strike him out.
Struik is still working. Still trying to defend.
Now he's almost in back control, I think.
The time is running out here.
Yeah, the cornering gets better now because they're calling for the left hand. Mindegos doesn't listen, but the call for the left hand would be good.
Yeah.
Because Willem has no chance to defend the left hand. The defensive game of Willem is very good. He has his elbows high up, very nicely together. So every strike Mindegos lands goes into the elbows. Has to watch out that he doesn't break his hands there.
That's a lot of damage done by Gerve here.
It might look brutal and it might look it is very controlling, but
oh,
he slips out.
He can slip out from the back here.
He slips out. You cannot believe it.
Oh, armbar attempt by Gerve.
He can't armbar him here.
Does he have the arm?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
I don't think so. Willem is very near to the head of Mindegos. That is good. He can move more to this side.
And
he does it.
The end of the contest.
Very nice. Yeah.
Wow.
And he survives another round.
Guys are going to go to distance here.
He survives another round. You cannot believe it.
Absolutely.
Mindegos is wasted. So I think Mindegos got that fight, of course. He should get the decision, but. Wow, incredible fighting spirit by Willem. Much respect for that one. Who would have thought that a heavyweight fight would go to the distance and was actually quite exciting and quite a good MMA fight actually. You had the striking, you had the takedowns. The takedowns of Mindegos were good. Especially because he was such a tall man and managed to get him down to the ground again and again. But that was a close fight because I think that Willem always had it on his hand to knock him out. Let's go to the judges' scorecards for the decision of this fight.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for the decision. All three judges scored that fight 30-27 for the winner by unanimous decision, Mindegos, Gerve!